Hey, in this video I'm trying to make an old wood material for this drawer. If you're interested like me, let's dive in. Alright, for the first step I download these two material, wood table worn and plywood, and I want to have both of these material in one material, which is easy. Shift the principal VSTF, select the first one, press Ctrl Shift T and load up the maps. And while everything is selected, press Ctrl G to group them in one node. You can edit the node by pressing Tab. And here I want to add a color, a mix color, not a color mix, to combine the base color and ambient occlusion. Put it on multiply. And it doesn't matter which one is top and which one is below, because for example 2 multiply 5 is 10, and also 5 multiply 2 is also 10. So for the multiply doesn't matter, and it actually multiply the mask like the numbers. So select the other principal BSF, press Ctrl Shift T and load up the other map. Select everything, press Ctrl G to make a group. And if you like me, you can see any output socket. That's because we didn't connect them. You can connect them easily like this. All right, let's set the materials. I don't want the displacement, so I turn it off. Put the normal on something like 0.2, and I think 3 for scale would be nice. Yep. And the other thing that I want to do is make the roughness darker. I use a ramp color. Color ramp? Why I can't say the name properly. And make it something like this to have a little bit highlight on the wood. And the plywood, I just set the scales to something like 5. Yeah, I think 4 would be nice too. Okay, I want to combine these two with a mix shader. And for the mask, I want to use a bevel node and 0.02 maybe be good, and duplicate it and put it on 0. For combining these two, I need another mix color and put it on subtract. Let's see what's going on here. Something like this. And another map we're going to use is map range, and put the from max 0.05, and I'm fine with it. Now let's talk about the mask, the procedural mask we made. It works correctly. But if I add, for example, this displacement, connect the displacement to the displacement socket, you can see it's run to some errors. That's because it's trying to calculate the bevel based on displacement. So just leaving there the procedural mask is not a good idea. And I'll tell you how to fix it. Okay, I want to add map. In this case, I think this one might work well. And also I put the link all of the asset I'm using for free on my Gumroad. We can go there and have them. Okay, for combining the bevels and procedural mask or bevels to another grunge texture, I need a mix color, put it on multiply and connect the mask and the other grunge texture. As you can see, it works some kind of well, and I rather to scale it down, scale it up to something like 3. Yeah, I'm fine with it. I'm not gonna use it as a final mask. I'm going to paint over it, and because I'm not paint all these details manually, I rather have a base to paint above it. So this is it. Now I'm going to fix the error we talked about by make a principal VSTF, connected as a base color, and make an image texture. I'm going to bake the mask we made on a new texture. Call it edge mask 01. I used 2K for the size of the mask and uncheck the alpha. Create image and let's open up in the UV editor. Select this one, go to render, and for bake type, choose diffuse and uncheck the direct and indirect. Make sure that you select the map and put the margin on 2 pixels. Hit the bake. Okay, this is it. Let's see. Perfect. Now we can get rid of all of these textures. Or except this one, I'm going to need it later, and even this. Now I'm going to connect it as the factor for the mixing shaders. The contrast is so low that we can't see anything. I add a range map of color ramp, doesn't matter, just one of them, and this is it. For the next step, I'm going to use texture paint. Select this one, hold Control Tab and put it on texture paint. Press N to open up the menus. In here, I wanna add a map as a stencil to start painting based on it. For example, this one. Okay, I open up the mask. I don't wanna do anything, just put it on stencil and that's there. For the controlling stencil, right click is for move, control right click is for rotate, and shift right click is for the scale. Here's another tip, that if you put the blend mode on mix and start painting, it's not a good thing here, let's say here, if I start painting here, as you can see, it paint based on the white part, but erase the parts on the texture that are in the black part. Look at it. It's erased the other part. So to fix that issue, I put it on add. And it's just adding the details, not erasing them. Okay, I put it on time-lapse and just, you know, paint. One more tip is to, for controlling brush, you can press F for the size and shift F for the strength. Okay, this is base that I come up with, and for next level I'm going to use another texture and use this one as brush. Just put it on plain view, and now I'm start to subtract from what I have drawn. Don't forget to check the rake and random. Okay, and one step is very important is to save the texture. So press Alt S in UV editor and save it somewhere safe. And don't forget to put it on non-color data. Alright, we made the base for the radial scratch. The next step is to add another texture. I'm gonna use the radial noise. Use it as a stencil. Put it up here. And start subtract from the base we made. Alright, let's save the texture and see what we have here. And I'm kind of fine with it. Okay, this is the first part of the setting material. The next part is to, I want to use this map. Control C. Come to the wormwood and paste it here. Add a mix color. And add a hue saturation value. Connect to the first socket and connect to the hue saturation and connect the hue saturation to the next socket and then use the mask as the factor. Let's see it. Let's first check the mask, for example, 2 or 3 was, I think, works well. Okay, connect the mix color to the principal BSDF. And now I want to make it darker and less saturated. It kind of makes the wood looks odd. And add a ramp here and kind of control it. Let's put it on 5. You can see some patterns repeating and I'm fine with it. This is just a small touch to make it look like it's old. Okay, for the next step I wanna add a dirt, a kind of dirt on the wood. Add another mix shader, connect to the first socket and add a principal BSDF and connect it to the other socket. For this one I want to use this imperfection that I made, connect it to the factor. Just let's add a color ramp. Set the coordinate to something like this and just, you know, a little bit tweak. But the principle, make sure that principle BSDF is rough enough. It's fully rough and just a dark color. And let's say I'm fine with it. For extra detail, we can mix these displacement with a mix color and add a displace modifier, connected to the displacement, connected to the height, and use the mask as a factor. And the worn as the second mask. Let's control the height with color, just a little bit height, not too much. And I think 201 would be nice, or even 0.002. Yeah, just to show a little bit difference. And for the metals, I don't do anything fancy, and hope you like it.